to make those differentiations. Entertainment values are very clear at Fox, and so are political values. And I think for us to be self-aware about that's important, right? We know what Jon Stewart is. He's a comedian who, I would say, commits some acts of journalism. In the same way that John Oliver is a comedian who commits a lot of acts of journalism. You might, I don't know, you might say Bill O'Reilly's an entertainer who commits acts of journalism, sometimes.
You mentioned Brian Williams, and I kind of wanted to get to the heart of that, and David Carr as well. First and foremost, in one of his most recent calls, prior to his passing, he described Brian Williams as two people, an entertainer and amusement.
Yeah.
Where do we as reporters draw the line between the two? And secondly, he also wrote later, further down, in regards to Brian Williams, his transgressions were not a fundamental part of his primary responsibilities. My question there is, was it not the primary responsibility of Brian Williams to tell the truth? And how does that affect public trust in journalists if they don't already trust us?
Yeah. Well, Brian Williams gets to the heart of what I was saying about every day we have a chance to regain people's trust or lose some of it. And unfortunately, the whole industry suffers when there's a high-profile scandal or crisis like there has been with Brian Williams. I'm glad you mentioned David's column, and I'd recommend everybody else read it. It was David's last column in print about Brian Williams, and it was sympathetic, which gets to that word I just used. It was important to show that sympathy because David was someone that was given a second chance, and he was suggesting that Brian Williams should be given a second. I'm cautious not to sound too critical of Williams because he has this amazing history and this amazing career in his past. But obviously what's happened has been severely damaging to him. And I don't know anybody in the industry who believes he can come back to nightly news. That's my honest assessment. But I do think he can have a second chance somewhere. I'd love to watch The Daily Show with Brian Williams. I think he could actually revolutionize what we think of as television news. If he did it with a little more humor, like The Daily Show does. But, if we did The Daily Show over here and Nightly News over here, if we had something in the middle that was willing to call BSBS, but do it from a journalistic place, that could be really, really significant. So I'm kind of rooting for his second chance to be doing something like that. Like, when I would watch him on Nightly News, I just wanted him to loosen his tie and make a joke. I wanted to see Brian Williams, who was on Letterman, although that's the Brian Williams that has apparently gotten him so much trouble. So, I don't know what's going to happen, and I don't know what NBC's going to do, but I think there's a real opportunity for him to try something new. I'm not kind of rooting for that, I'm not campaigning for it, but I wonder if that's the outcome.
So where do we draw the line as reporter and entertainer? Because, that's something Carr mentioned, was you can see him on Nightly News, very serious, and then you see him on, David Letterman, he's kind of a loose, funny guy, so where do we draw that line?
What line do you mean?
Between news reporter, article, respectable, and funny guy on the side, making jokes.
Yeah.
You take it seriously.
I don't think I have a good profound answer for you, because most of me wants to say, just be a reporter, but then again, the personal brand thing is really important. There was a reason why Brian Williams went on Letterman. And it wasn't just because he might have wanted to be a late night host. It was also because NBC wanted him to be on, wanted him to promote himself and reach younger people. I don't want to say that the audience is at fault here, but David was right in his column. We want our nightly news anchors to be more than human. We want them to be everything, entertainers and newsmen, symbols and all of that. So maybe over time there's a reassessment.